Hello students of class 11. Welcome to the online tutorial classes for Vidya Bhavan High Secondary School. This video is for class 11 nutrition. The chapter that I will continue today is the protein. This video is part 9. Okay, in the previous video I have discussed about the Zwitteran and isoelectric point, and today I will start with the quality of the protein. So there are some terms that you can say by this the protein quality can be measured. Their ratio, their mass and their equations are all different. So it is about the quality of proteins. So here you have to keep in mind these things, remember it, these things very carefully, and also have to read the reactions or the ratios what are given in your book. Till the first thing that I am talking about, it is BV or biological value. So what is the ratio of it? The BV is equal to retained nitrogen by absorbed nitrogen into 100. That is the food, from the food that the nitrogen percentage is absorbed, retained by the absorbed part of the nitrogen into 100, it is the BV or biological value of some food, some protein actually. Then the NPU, net protein utilization. Net protein utilization, what is NPU? It is also retained nitrogen by intake nitrogen. Here you can see the absorbed part. After intake, some of the part only can be absorbed, all parts are not. And so here you can understand that BV is more accurate than this NPU. So it is retained nitrogen by intake of nitrogen into 100. Okay. So next is net dietary protein ratio. So what is it? Protein energy, the energy that are coming only from protein by net dietary intake, the full amount that we are taking into NPUOP. So we have to use the NPU value here also. Okay, so the next is PER or protein efficiency ratio. Protein efficiency ratio. What is it? That is gain weight by protein. Gain weight by gram by protein intake. It is also by gram. Okay. So this ratio is called the protein efficiency ratio. Okay. The next is NPR. There are many terms like NPR. NPR is the modified part of the PER, so I'm not going to write in detail. Then the digestibility coefficient also. Digestibility coefficient. Here it refers to the percentage of the ingested protein absorbed into the bloodstream after the process of the digestion. After the process of the digestion, how much amount can be absorbed. Okay, so these are the first part of the maintaining or functioning, or you can say finding out the quality of the proteins. Then I will discuss about the scoring system, that is the amino acid score. Okay, let me erase this up and then I will telling you the scoring system. There are many kind of the scoring system also. Let me discuss. Okay, one more thing. In the BV part, biological value, we actually take the BV of egg as 100 and we are calculating the other foods BV to taking it that constant. Okay, so this thing I am also mentioning. So now the scoring system. Scoring system. scoring system. So first one is amino acid score. Amino acid score. So what is it? Amino acid score is milligram of amino acid in 1 gram test protein by milligram of amino acid in 1 gram reference protein. So we are calculating the 1 gram of amino acid test protein's amino acid score by taking the reference protein's amino acid value. So it is the main target or the math behind this forming of amino acid score. Okay, so there are also, I'm telling you, the amino acid score of egg is actually 100 and the meat is not also bad, it is more about 70. And the lower, if I can tell you, then you can see the soybean, it is only 57. The wheat 42. So here you can understand that the in the very first of this chapter I told you that the animal proteins are good amount of the protein and good proteins actually, and the plant proteins are not good like that, because the amino acids, the essential amino acids, are actually present in large amount in the animal protein, not in plant protein. Here, as we calculating the amino acid score, here we can easily see that in the egg it is 100, the meat it is 70, as both are animal proteins. But here two plant proteins are also present, that is soybean and wheat. As you know, the soybean has the highest amount of the protein, that is 40% near about, but the scoring of the amino acid is very low, like 57. So that is why we can easily understand that it is not that much of good like that. Okay, so now the next is, that is PDCAAS. Okay, PDCAAS. So it is the protein digestibility corrected amino acid score, and it is the official method of forming or maintaining the or evaluating the quality of the protein after the correction of the digestibility. Provide the amino acid equal to the excess amount of the requirement, receives a PDCAAS is about 1. It is only, you have to learn the name and you have to know what is it, that's it, not more thing you have to learn. Okay, that is all enough. So here in the assessing of the quality of the protein, the some biological assessment we learn here, the BV, NPU, PER, NPR, these things we learn. After that, some amino acid scoring we learn, that is the amino acid score and PDCAAS. And this all from this chapter. I'm completing this chapter with this video. I will make some new video from a new chapter. Till then, thank you very much.